Welcome to the John and Heidi Show podcast. John and Heidi. Here's John and Heidi.
Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show this weekend. Today is a special day, Heidi. Do you know what today is?
What is today, John?
I thought you'd never ask. Let's do the whole darn weekend. How's that sound?
Okay.
February 15th, Saturday, is National Gumdrop Day, National Singles Awareness Day. It's the day after Valentine's, see?
Okay.
National Wisconsin Day as well.
All right.
Sunday, the 16th, National Almond Day, and National Do a Grouch a Favor Day. Hey, will you do me a favor?
Sure.
Am I a grouch?
Sometimes, but so am I, so it depends on the day.
Mm-hmm. I've got a guest coming up later in the program, too, Jack Kerfoot. He's a scientist, an energy expert, and the author of Fueling America, An Insider's Journey. Going to be chatting with him in just a little bit here on the program about our energy conundrum. We'll be chatting with Jack Kerfoot here, like I said, before you know it. Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show this weekend.
Student loan debt is out of control for many people. Are you one of them? The average graduate walks away with anywhere from $25,000 to $40,000 in student loans. Believe it or not, 2% even manage to owe over $100,000 by the time they graduate. If you have several different student loans, let us consolidate them into one loan and one payment at singlestudentloan.com. If you have only one student loan, we may be able to offer you a better rate to help you get that loan paid off sooner at singlestudentloan.com. That's singlestudentloan.com.
Now, surveys and studies and such brought to you by BetterCreditCards.com. A survey by the New York Post found that 200 couples get divorced on Valentine's Day every year.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah, so hopefully you guys made it through this week okay. By golly, I'd hate to hear that. Wouldn't that be a sad time?
That'd be a really sad time.
Yeah, it'd be
You'd
really sad.
Remember that
so,
forever.
Mm-hmm. That would be bad. So, again, hopefully you all made it through. And, again, I've got a link to the story if you want to read all the details in that. It's in the show notes for today at johnandheidishow.com.
When was the last time you got a new credit card? If you have a card that's been in your purse or wallet for a long time, you should check and see if you're getting the best rates. You may find a better credit card that will give you the points you want or cashback options you don't get right now. At BetterCreditCards.com, you see all the major credit card companies and their best offers. Let them compete to earn your business. And if the one you have right now is better, keep it. Find a card that's a better fit for you at BetterCreditCards.com. That's BetterCreditCards.com.
This is Your Brain on Drugs, brought to you by TimeForRehab.com. An Ohio man was arrested Monday after authorities say he called the police more than 20 times to get help looking for a lost hoodie.
Yeah. Oh,
32-year-old Harv Gardner faces felony charges of disruption of public services. They say he requested police assistance, and officers responded. When police arrived, he only wanted rides around town to find his hoodie that he lost.
Oh,
they said he was highly intoxicated. They told him to go back to bed, but he continued calling and gave different locations for them to respond. He's being held at the Hamilton Justice Center, scheduled to appear in court Tuesday. So, yeah, that's a bad plan, but that is the kind of thing that happens when your brain is on drugs. John and Heidi. Now, big screen, little screen, brought to you by ChannelSurferTV.com. We are a whole week away from the Oscars. That happened last weekend. Joaquin Phoenix's Oscar acceptance speech went viral when he called out humans for a thing called speciesism. And the funny thing is, nobody really knew what that was, and now there are many people who say, well, I think he made that word up.
I didn't bother watching it. I haven't watched any of the replays. I really don't.
Yeah, I saw the video. It was floating around on the old Facebook thing there.
A bunch of people who have no idea what real life people are going through, and I just don't care what their thoughts are on anything, honestly.
Well, movie industry continues to be shocked by Parasite winning Best Picture at the Oscars. Have you seen the movie, Heidi?
I have not.
Do you want to see the movie, Heidi?
No.
It's the first foreign language film to ever win the Best Picture at the Oscars. So there you go. Thanks for listening to Big Screen, Little Screen, brought to you by ChannelSurferTV.com.
It's a new year. Have you made a resolution to quit drinking or to finally get away from drugs for good? These are both habits that are hard to kick, but you can do it. We want to help you. TimeForRehab.com is here to help you find the help you need with your particular situation. If you want to make this year the year you get the help you need to live a normal life again, start with a little help from us at TimeForRehab.com. That's time, www.funkymonkeyshirts4rehab.com.
Now your scoop of the day, brought to you by funkymonkeyshirts.com. I saw some of the St. Patrick's stuff that's on there. Pretty cute stuff. Again, funkymonkeyshirts.com. Hooters is giving away free chicken wings. Oh, dang it. This was on Valentine's Day. I'm reading this way too late, Heidi. Otherwise, I'd have been there.
Giving away to everybody?
You just come well, in and... just to single people. So I wouldn't have gotten any anyway.
Oh.
And you're supposed to do, it was called Shred Your Ex Party. So you put a picture of your ex in a shredder, you push a button, and it grinds up a picture of your ex, and then they give you some free wings.
Okay.
I don't know how many people showed up for that, but doesn't sound like my kind of party anyway. A couple of stories here about Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, because, you know, they wanted to stay out of the limelight, remember?
Oh, yes.
So they wanted to just, you know, lay low and go to Canada and let people forget they even exist. And, oh, wait, what's this? They were partying with J-Lo and A-Rod.
Of course they were.
At the J.P. Morgan Wealth Management Convention in Miami. What? They're facing backlash after appearing in Miami at a wealth management event when people are saying, wait a minute, I thought you wanted to stay out of the limelight.
I thought you wanted people to just leave you alone.
What are you doing? Mm-hmm. Like, guys, stay home. Watch Netflix or something. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe they've already realized that it's awfully cold when you step out of the spotlight.
Hey, that's my saying. You can't say my saying. Mm. It's awfully cold when you get out of the spotlight. I had it written down.
I just think they figured it out a lot sooner than they thought they were going
probably.
To.
Yeah, probably. Study looked at 475 NFL games among 30 teams, and they found that in cities where the home team lost a game on a Sunday, the following Monday, there was a 16% spike in the consumption of high-fat, high-calorie processed foods. So if your team lost, you pigged out.
You're going to binge.
And ate a bunch of stuff you shouldn't have eaten. So that's what they're saying.
I can see that.
You know, I don't know. Maybe not. I'm not even a football fan, and I eat poorly, so
right.
I can't blame it on, oh, those darn football team peoples. I don't have a team. I don't know what to say.
The darn team.
O.J. Simpson blasted Gayle King for asking about Kobe Bryant's rape allegations, saying that this isn't the right time to bring up his past.
Absolutely true.
That whole thing has gotten blown way out of proportion, though, and like she's fearing for her life now because there are people that are getting really, really mean about it. Moving on, Monica Lewinsky is in the news. She attended the Vanity Fair Oscars dinner last weekend, and they posted this online. And what does that have to do? What does she have to do with the Oscars? Why would she be going to that?
Who knows?
I don't understand quite how she would get an invite to that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, what are your qualifications? Well, here's my resume. These pages are stuck together here. They're just stuck. Here you go. I should not end on that. We're going to end on, we'll end on this. Kylie Jenner told Harper's Bazaar she likes to eat bone broth all day long. What? What is bone broth?
Bone broth is very good for you.
Is it?
Yes.
Kylie also says her favorite snacks are barbecue Lays, chili cheese Fritos, and extra cheesy Goldfish. Funny thing is, they're all made by the same company. I think that was nothing more than an endorsement.
Possibly.
I don't think she's ever even had a chili cheese
Frito. But I actually put bone
broth
in a lot of the things that I cook.
Do you really?
I don't even know because it is
I like
so
bone
good
broth?
For you. You like what I cook.
There you go. I must love it.
Yeah.
I'm like Kylie Jenner.
Just like Kylie Jenner.
Just like Kylie Jenner. Thanks for listening to The John and Heidi Show.
Student loan debt is out of control for many people. Are you one of them? The average graduate walks away with anywhere from $25,000 to $40,000 in student loans. Believe it or not, 2% even manage to owe over $100,000 by the time they graduate. If you have several different student loans, let us consolidate them into one loan and one payment at singlestudentloan.com. If you have only one student loan, we may be able to offer you a better rate to help you get that loan paid off sooner at singlestudentloan.com. That's singlestudentloan.com.
Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show this weekend. We've got a guest named Jack Kerfoot. He's a scientist, he's an energy expert, and the author of a new book called Fueling America, An Insider's Journey. Now, he's been working on this for quite some time. Jack, how long did it take to put this book together?
Well, you could, since it's an insider's journey of my life, you could say it's a 40-year career look back of my career traveling around the world, working with scientists, ministers, energy specialists, sheiks, and potentates around the world.
Holy cow. So this is like your life's work then, all inside of a book.
Well, it's yes, but the real story is not so much my career, although I do have some interesting stories. It's really how the energy demands around the world have changed. Why did the oil prices go up and then go down? Why have we moved from coal away from coal? And what's the recent change in the justification and rationale to move to renewable energy?
Now, let's talk about the person listening and how this affects them. So when we hear about the different changes that happen, whether it's, you know, switching to solar and wind and hydroelectric and all of those things, how does that affect the average person?
Well, we have to realize that right now, with technology that's developed over the last 15 years, the cheapest form of power, if we take out all tax credits and subsidies, is actually onshore wind, and it averages about 5.2 cents a kilowatt hour. The average price of power in the United States right now is 13.3 cents per kilowatt hour. And after onshore wind, the next cheapest is solar, and then the next cheapest is hydro, and then only natural gas. Coal is probably three times as much or more than the cost of power than onshore wind. And then we look at other sources like natural gas. That's a little more expensive than hydro, but still, all forms of fossil fuel are more expensive than renewable energy.
So it's interesting. It seems to me like that most people don't realize that, because if it's cheaper to do it that way, if that's a more energy efficient way to do it, why don't we have more of that?
Well, you have to realize that utilities, each state has their own utility board. And so when a utility wants to make a change, they have to come forward with a justification. First of all, it's power reliability, power grid reliability, and second of all, it's cost. Typically, what they do is they defer major capital investment until the current power plant, which may be coal or natural gas, is about near the end of their cycle or their life cycle. Typically, power plants, whether it's coal, natural gas, or even nuclear, are licensed for a 40-year period of time. So typically, they look at it in a staged manner. But if you look at states, let's say in the Great Plains states, all the way from Minnesota or North Dakota all the way down to Texas, they've been aggressively moving to wind and solar over the last 15 years. The U.S. passed an energy policy in 2005, which gave tax subsidies for oil and gas, which is why you saw the fracking, also for nuclear and renewable energy. So 15 years ago, a wind turbine might generate maybe 1 megawatt of power. Today, the wind turbines that we're seeing being installed will generate anywhere from 8 to 12 megawatts of power. So the power output is increasing, which drives down the cost. So people don't even see it because the utilities, many of the utilities, have been making that move over the last 15 years.
Now, that switch has been happening. What do you say when people are still thinking that it's impractical to move away from fossil fuels to these renewable energy sources?
Well, the DOE, Department of Energy, published a report late last year that basically said with current technology, assuming no more innovation, that the U.S. could be 80% on renewable energy right now. So the reality is the technology's here. Now, you have to realize not everywhere area in the United States is the same type of environment. Let's say the Northwest, where I live, we have abundant wind. We have solar in the eastern part of the state, quite a bit of hydro, and also geothermal. We look at the Northeast, it's more wind and solar. If we look at the Great Plains, obviously wind and solar as well, but also some hydro, depending on where you live. In the southeast, let's say from Louisiana over to Florida, what you typically have is abundant radiant energy for solar, but a limited amount of wind. So those areas wouldn't be able to go 100% renewable at this time with current technology.
So while we're on the subject of this, let's talk a little bit about electric vehicles. I'm seeing more and more of those. Do you think that that's going to catch on even more? And is there a reason that that's not caught on quicker?
Well, it's a technology aspect of it, but we're seeing real breakthroughs in technology. We're seeing new batteries that are coming out, not just lithium-ion batteries, but also other new types of batteries that are allowing a vehicle to drive not just 200 or 300 miles on a charge, but up to 500 miles on a single charge. More importantly, these new batteries are now saying that they can get a complete recharge in less than 5 minutes. So that's going to revolutionize the whole power industry from that standpoint. To the consumer, they'll still drive to, instead of a gas station, it'll be called a fueling station, and they'll simply go in and plug their car in and go inside the store. To the gas stations, who people say, well, they'll push back because they don't want to lose the loss of sale of gasoline. Actually, their revenue for the gas stations or fueling station is when you go inside and buy those munchies or soft drinks from that standpoint. So 5 minutes to recharge your car. There's no pollution at all from the exhaust fumes whatsoever, and then it'll be very quick, and right now it'll be significantly cheaper than gasoline to recharge your car.
That is amazing. Well, Jack, thank you very much for taking some time to visit with us about this.
John, it was a pleasure. Anytime.
Again, Jack Kerfoot. The book is called Fueling America, An Insider's Journey. I've got a link to find it in the show notes for today at johnandheidishow.com.
Do you have a lucky shirt? FunkyMonkeyShirts.com has several lucky shirts to wear next month for St. Patrick's Day. Or if it's a really lucky shirt, you can wear it every day. Green shirts, four-leaf clovers, Irish sayings, and more. Don't wait. If you order your lucky shirt right now, it can be here in time to wear for St. Patrick's Day. Find t-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, and more at FunkyMonkeyShirts.com. That's FunkyMonkeyShirts.com.
Fun fact for you, Heidi.
What's that, John?
Dogs understand some English words.
Probably not the ones you just said.
I don't even understand what I just said. Some owners of disobedient dogs may have trouble believing this, but dogs can learn to recognize a vocabulary of about 165 words. Unsurprisingly, dogs respond best to short words, as well as words with hard consonants like a T or an R, which may explain why they can't hear or why they can hear treat three rooms away. If you're trying to get your dog's vocabulary to be, they say, be consistent. For example, always call it a treat, not, you know, a snack. We had that discussion. Instead of breakfast, lunch, or dinner, they're saying call it dinner. Also, don't believe the myth. Old dogs can learn new tricks and new words. So there you go. Going to teach our dogs some fun words today. Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show.
When was the last time you got a new credit card? If you have a card that's been in your purse or wallet for a long time, you should check and see if you're getting the best rates. You may find a better credit card that will give you the points you want or cashback options you don't get right now. At bettercreditcards.com, you see all the major credit card companies and their best offers. Let them compete to earn your business. And if the one you have right now is better, keep it. Find a card that's a better fit for you at bettercreditcards.com. That's bettercreditcards.com.
Now, a news headline from somewhere in this world, Dateline Russia. A popular Russian blogger who wrote a lengthy post bashing Vladimir Putin was murdered in his hotel room.
Oh, my.
Or as they call it in Russia, he died a natural death.
Oh, my.
Yeah, that's sad. When this story came out, you can check tape if you want. Go back and listen to the archives. I remember when we read this story, it was just like a month, maybe 2 months ago, I said, ooh, I got a feeling this guy ain't going to be around long, because that's not a safe thing to do in that country. And now here it is, like a month later, 2 months later, however long it was.
Depending on who you're speaking out against, it's not a safe thing to do in this country either.
So I'm not speaking out against anybody.
No.
I love all of you on the right and the left. Would you just stop? Thanks for listening to a news headline from somewhere in this world.
It's a new year. Have you made a resolution to quit drinking or to finally get away from drugs for good? These are both habits that are hard to kick, but you can do it. We want to help you. TimeForRehab.com is here to help you find the help you need with your particular situation. If you want to make this year the year you get the help you need to live a normal life again, start with a little help from us at TimeForRehab.com. That's TimeForRehab.com.
Now some weird news brought to you by WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com. A former Ohio football coach is not too thrilled with the NFL over their Super Bowl halftime show, Jennifer Lopez and Shakira program. He says he intends to sue them because of their revealing outfits that put him, quote, in danger of hellfire. Minister Dave Dobmeier says he's planning to sue the NFL, also Pepsi and Fox TV and several other companies, for the crotch-grabbing performance. He says, I think we ought to go sit down in a courtroom and present this as evidence of how whoever is keeping me from getting into the kingdom of heaven. He said the Super Bowl halftime extravaganza showcased two women gyrating to these songs. He put the songs on there. I'm not going to go through all that. And he basically called it porn, is what he called it. Yeah. And yeah. I know there's a lot of folks that are not happy
Good
with
luck,
what
buddy.
Happened.
I mean,
but I don't know if he's going to win, you know, again. He added that he's spoken with a lawyer and plans to go forward with a lawsuit against the NFL and these other parties, claiming that he would be satisfied by scoring an $867 trillion settlement.
Oh, my. Yeah.
Is that all?
Yeah, that's
$867 trillion? Dollars?
My guess. What's the kingdom of heaven worth?
Well, you would hope it's worth more than that, but if that's what it's really about.
Yeah,
sad story.
I don't think that's going to go anywhere.
I don't think so either, but that's why it is today's Weird News. Now your moment of duh, brought to you by SingleStudentLoan.com. A Florida man, armed with a knife, was arrested outside the White House after threatening to assassinate President Trump. 25-year-old Roger Hedgepeth was busted
25.
After making alarming threats to a Secret Service agent who was patrolling about a block away from the White House. He said to the Secret Service agent, "I'm here to assassinate President Trump." He was warned, according to a police report. He also threatened, "I have a knife to do it with." Authorities say he was found with a 3.5-inch knife in a sheath on his left hip and an empty pistol holder on his right hip. I'm not sure why it was empty.
Wonder where that went.
Trump had no scheduled events and was believed to be in the White House at the time. From Brandon, Florida, he was arrested on a charge of making threat to do bodily harm and possession of a prohibited weapon. So, what a bizarre story. That could have been our weird news today, but it's our moment of duh because that's not a smart thing to do. Doesn't matter who's in that office. I mean,
no,
doesn't
it's the
matter
president
who
of
it
the
is.
United
yeah, you
States.
Respect that person.
Exactly.
Respect the office at least. And, you know, just be patient. That person, whoever it is, wouldn't
be there forever.
Just
That's right.
Calm down. Thanks for listening. This has been today's Moment of Duh.
When was the last time you got a new credit card? If you have a card that's been in your purse or wallet for a long time, you should check and see if you're getting the best rates. You may find a better credit card that will give you the points you want or cashback options you don't get right now. At bettercreditcards.com, you see all the major credit card companies and their best offers. Let them compete to earn your business. And if the one you have right now is better, keep it. Find a card that's a better fit for you at bettercreditcards.com. That's bettercreditcards.com.
Now, fake news or Florida? Heidi, tell me, is this a true story from the great state of Florida, or is it fake news made up just to trick you and amuse me?
Okay.
All right, here we go. Fake news or Florida? A Parrish man was arrested for assaulting his wife with a Taco Bell burrito. Fake news or Florida?
That was Florida.
It was Florida. I believe we just... Did we just talk about this?
Well, we talked about a pork chop one, but
oh,
I think we did
a
burrito one a long time ago.
Yeah, it was a while back. But yeah, you're right. We did recently talk about somebody who smacked his spouse or
girlfriend.
Really,
there's a lot of food abuse in
I think you guys
Florida.
Need to calm down. I don't understand what's going on. Here's the thing. If I got a burrito, you know what I'm going to do with it? I'm going to eat that burrito. I am going to eat that burrito. I'm not going to smack anybody with it. It's just a bad idea. But this is definitely fake news or Florida and a very bizarre one. It happens to be a true story. Thanks for listening to The John and Heidi Show.
John and Heidi.
This portion of The John and Heidi Show is brought to you by The John and Heidi Show. That sounds kind of funny, but it's true. Go to your local radio station and ask them to start carrying The John and Heidi Show. Here's the best part. They can carry the show for free. They play a couple commercials, but it doesn't cost them anything every month. So if you know a radio station that could use a little bit of help, send them our way. Send them to johnandheidishow.com. Again, johnandheidishow.com. We would love to do a radio program in your community. Then you could listen to the podcast and listen to us on the radio.
John and Heidi.
We always like to wrap things up around here with good news. Guess what, Heidi? I have some good news.
Okay.
Are you ready for some good
always
news?
Always ready for
All
good
right.
news.
Here's a good news story. And by the way, I'm going to just say, I'm going to plant this seed in some folks' minds. If you're listening and you're thinking, what could I do to make people happy? Here's a story. Well, I clicked on the wrong one, so it's going to take a second. Here's the headline, though. The headline is, Idaho firefighters spend their day shoveling snow for strangers.
Aww.
It's a cool story. And I got to tell you, when I was a kid, my brothers and I and my sisters and I used to do this all the time. And it really makes you feel good and it makes other people really, really happy. So it says here, a surveillance camera at an Idaho Falls home captures firefighters performing acts of kindness after a snowstorm. The video of an Idaho Falls ambulance parked on the street with several firefighters shoveling snow off driveways and sidewalks. One resident was amazed at what he witnessed and sent the footage to East Idaho News. He said, "I actually thought my wife was the one that did it, and she thought that I was the one that did it. We didn't realize until I thanked her for it that night that she didn't do it. She thought it was me. We were both totally surprised. That's when they checked tape, and they found out that, oh, wait a minute. It wasn't either of us. It was some firefighters." Idaho Falls Fire Department a spokesperson there, Carrie Hammond, says she had no idea the firefighters with the department were doing this, but she wasn't surprised. She says they're always doing stuff like that. Nelson says they're thankful for the firefighters who already performed an important job in the community, and said that they were glad that they would take the time to serve him by shoveling the walk. I got to tell you, when I was a kid, we had a bunch of rental properties in my hometown, and we would quite often we would be there shoveling for, you know, the home that my dad owned. We'd be shoveling that sidewalk, and we would just keep going and shovel like an extra sidewalk on each side.
Aww.
And it was a lot of elderly people who lived there. And it was so cool because you would get the coolest thank yous. They'd step out on the sidewalk and try to give you cookies or whatever. And we're like, no, it's not a big deal. And I remember one lady gave me 2 bits. You know what 2 bits is, Heidi?
It was 25 cents.
Yes, it's a quarter. I had no idea. She goes, well, I want to at least give you 2 bits. I'm like, 2 bits of what? Oh, what does that mean? So anyway, if you have some time to do something kind for someone else, do it. It's going to make you feel so good. Time to say goodbye, Heidi.
Goodbye, Heidi.
Goodbye, everybody. Have a great day. Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show.